नमस्कार टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड फ्रेंड्स, आज ऑल ऑफ अस वी नो दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड ए सीरीज ऑफ वेबिनार एंड द कॉज इज ऑब्वियसली नोन टू ऑल ऑफ अस ड्यू टू कोविड 19 आउटब्रेक. सो ऑल ओवर कंट्री वी हैव लॉकडाउन एंड ऑल आवर स्टूडेंट्स इंक्लूडिंग स्कूल एजुकेशन टू हायर एजुकेशन. So there are nearly 33 crore students, 330 million students across the country who are at home with their parents or somewhere. So due to lockout, and the reason is obviously known that we are fighting for COVID-19. But no occasion should stop us learning, and the digital technology is the only way now to reach out to everyone. So we thought that let us have an interaction with academia across the country so that we learn some new tools and continuously do some capacity building among ourselves and learn further. So today, since 7th of this month, we have started the webinar, and today I am happy to introduce Dr. Jayashree Shinde ji, and I think many of the academia who are already here, they are well introduced to Dr. Jayashree Shinde ji. But still, for all your information, I would like to inform all of you that Dr. Jayashree Shinde ji is the director of Teaching Learning Center in the Department of Educational Technology, Srimati Nathibai Damodara Thakarse University, SNDT, Women University, popularly known as, from Mumbai. And now over to Madam Dr. Jayashree Shinde, Director, Teaching Learning Center, Educational Technology Department, SNDT, Women University, Mumbai. Madam, please go ahead.
Thank you very much, Dr. Behera. It's always a pleasure to work with CIIT. So let us start. I'm sharing my screen with you. You can see one concept map. This concept map is developed by my students. I think this is individual student's assignment. I will now again zoom out. This is on Bruno's theory of instruction. So let me zoom out. Now you can see the complete concept map. There is no need of explaining, I think, what is concept map and which is very important pedagogy, where students can develop relationships between concepts in their own brain. So it really helps in conceptualization, developing their own schema. This is another concept map developed by other student. This is pretty old assignment. This is collaborative concept map. So only one student was not developing this concept map, but this concept map assignment was shared with five other students. So you can see their names. We are also there. Teachers are also in this file. But three, four, five students were developing this concept map. Four students, I think, were developing this concept map. So I am going to talk about this kind of collaboration. And now we will go to Google Drawing to see how we can share with our students. So if we prepare one file and share a blank file with our students, then there is possibility that they all can work on this at their end, and we can have even our discussion with them later on. But this can be one of the activities which we can give to our students during lockdown period. I will go to Gmail. This is my email account, or we can even go to Google. All of us know that if we click on this nine squares Google Apps, we can see all many, many apps here, and we can reach to our Drive. So this icon is Drive for all Google Apps. There are many Google Apps, such as Google Slides, Google Documents, Google Spreadsheets, where we can work collaboratively. So even if you want to type or develop next timetable or schedule of a workshop, you can work in Google Doc, or you can work in Google Spreadsheets, Google Slides. Google Slides can be one collaborative activity where students, this is actually a slide presentation, and many students can go on developing slides in only one file. Instead of emailing files to each other, they can distribute their work and they can add slides here, and each student can work on each slide. So I just opened it to show you Google Slide. We are not planning to work on it today. We will go again to this. I'm clicking on this new. Then I'm going on in more. As soon as I take my mouse on more, we can see Google Drawing. I hope this is visible. So I'm clicking on this Google Drawing, and this Google Drawing environment has opened. We can click here and we can give some name to it. I'm giving Addy. Now I want my students to develop. I'm deliberately taking the same topic which I have used in my manual. Can you see I have drawn a box here? So from where have I drawn the box? As you all know, in all tools, we have the shapes, text, insert images facilities. So this is shape. As soon as we click on shapes, there are so many shapes. There are arrows. There are callouts. There are some equation signs. So from here, I have taken this shape and I will go to text. Decide my text area. I have typed Addy here. Let me make it bold. Let me increase its size. Let me make it center align. I can even change color. I can type size and make it bigger. Now I stop here because I want my students to work on it. So I, in the same file, I don't want them to use any other file. So I go on this share. Currently it is privately shared only to me, because just now I created this file. Nobody has seen or nobody is collaborating with my file. So I click on this and I type some names. Say I type Nidhi, then I type Samia, then some students are maybe available with me. So let me see whether they are there. Give me 1 minute to see their names. Yeah, Samiksha is also there. So let me share this file with some students. I have typed their email IDs in share. These are the email IDs. I can add more students also here, but currently let me restrict to this, and they all have edit rights. See, so they work, they can work in my file. I click on done, so they will receive invitation. Now they will get the invitation in their email. And they will start. When I share this invitation, let me for example, again, share it with Samiksha. If we click on notify, we can add note here. Dear all, please complete this concept map on adding related concepts. So this message will also go to them. Now you can see there are already two girls. Samiksha is here and Samia is here. Now suppose all students are sitting in there. Now they are also sitting in lockdown and every day we are conducting their classes. I want to talk to them, but now they are not in our Zoom. So can you see this show chat? And even one more girl has come. Nidhi Pandey has come. So I open this chat. They have already started working. So like us, they can also be in chat. I'm not doing anything now. Let them do for one more minute. And if I move my mouse, you can see their names. So as a teacher, I can sit remote at remote place. I don't need to do anything. I don't need to talk to them. As they go on doing something, I can see their names, what they are doing, who is doing what. Meanwhile, I'll show you some more features. These all are connectors. So if I take this curve connector, okay, Samia is saying she will connect all this. So can you see, even if they are not talking to each other, they can chat and they can complete the work. So students learn to be patient with each other, collaborate, distribute tasks. They take up responsibilities. Now one student changed color of boxes. Nidhi, Miss Nidhi, would you meanwhile, if there are any important questions, would you speak?
Yes, ma'am. I'll just take up a few questions. This says that one question is that Is it necessary to have the email ID of the those
yeah.
who want to
yes, yes.
we can do it another way maybe.
Yeah, unfortunately yes, because this is Google tool. Google form, when you respond as a remote person from anywhere, you don't need Gmail ID to access the Google form for survey. But these tools where you are collaborating, because this particular file should open in your own account. And if you have Google, then only you have Google Apps. And then only this file will open at your end. That's why you need to have Gmail account. There are so many Google tools that many a times we say that we are not Google agents, but unfortunately or fortunately, Google has given us so many apps. You can see here. So, and even if you see here, so it really helps if we have Google account.
Right. Ma'am, somebody is asking that how at a time, how many members can be connected with each other?
Many. Google has not given any restriction, but as a teacher, I will give restriction that not more than 8 persons should generally work in one environment, because there will be chaos. See, I could have easily shared. Meanwhile, I will share, show you how to share this kind of file with. Let me first find out where they are working. Yeah, they are working here. I can share this file with link also. Do you see this get shareable link?
Mm-hmm.
So if I get this link, and instead of view, if I say edit. And if I edit anyone with the link, and I make it edit, then you can imagine if I paste this particular link now in chat, there are 354 participants. At least 54 participants will log in, enter into this particular drawing tool, and everybody will start typing, and nobody will know who is typing what, and there will be total chaos. So in our class also, now they are easily working because there are only 3 girls. Even if 3 more girls join, then also it's okay. Because then they can chat here. So that's why, as we have rule for our group classroom work, that we should not give group work for more than 6 students in one group. The same rule applies here. So we can duplicate the files. See, you can make a copy and you can say add group 1, group 2, like this. You will not share with the same people. You will share this file with other 6 persons. So if you have decided to give this kind of task, blank files, make multiple files and share it with 6, 6, 7, 7 students each. So even if there is a large classroom, if you have enrollment of about 60 students in the class, then also you can share 10 multiple files like this. That is the advantage. There is no restriction because this is free tool. You see any other tool, it's not free completely. Every tool has, unfortunately, some limitations, some paid version. Beyond 3, beyond 5, beyond 6, it does not allow you to create. Even Padlet is a very strong tool, but now all new registered users get only 3 Padlets. So this is happening with many tools. Bubble.us is also a nice tool. But all these are paid versions beyond a certain limit. Any other question?
Ma'am, in the meanwhile, somebody is asking that the chat box option is not coming in there. So is it only possible when people log in?
Yes. Because you need, otherwise there is comment.
Mm-hmm.
Can you see this comment history part? I will just reduce this. Yeah. See, this is comment. So you can comment, but chat is mainly when people are collaborating to each other. And disadvantage is as soon as you log out, the entire chat will go for you because this is synchronous too. if you want people to work in asynchronous environment, you can of course do that. You can tell that I have created this. Whenever you want, you just log in and complete your work. We generally give this kind of work also to students. Whenever you want overnight, you work. But that time you need to use this comment. So you can open comment history and you can read all comments. But you cannot read chat any other time. One beautiful thing in Google Drawing, why not PowerPoint? Why Google Drawing? Because see, you can stretch it. The canvas can be enlarged to any extent. Right? So as they are drawing, if they are completely engrossed, as a teacher, I can increase their canvas. Now see, Samiksha is saying Nidhi for sub-points use lighter color.
ma'am, somebody is asking that can others, those who are participating, can they edit others' thing that they are, yes, work that they are doing?
Yes, they can. So I will show you one more feature.
And the admins also, like yours also, can they edit?
This is, I'm the owner of this file.
Yeah.
So naturally, I can do anything. I can delete this file also. But if Nidhi deletes, it will go from her end, not from mine. But that's why the group should be smaller. Mm-hmm. And most importantly, in file option, there is version history option. See version history. So I can see version history. So I know exactly what is done by Samia, what is done by Samiksha. And now they are doing it continuously. If I close this, again if they enter, one more version history will get opened. So I can, and
track
as
them.
You go
see,
to this version, you get this restore this version. This is very dangerous because if I click restore this version, the entire efforts, whatever they have taken are gone.
Mm-hmm.
But by mistake in this version, if they delete everything by mistake, then I can restore my previous version. So that is helpful.
So ma'am, this can be, another question is, this can be done on mobile also?
Actually, little bit difficult, not completely difficult, impossible. But of course, picking up shapes, drawing shapes may be a bit difficult in mobile.
Right, because it will be, it will have a smaller screen.
Smaller screen.
It will be, and you have to work with two fingers and then...
Because there are drive facilities there on mobile. Google Drive, we can install. But then it becomes difficult to draw actually. Many nowadays children do many things. let me just try on my mobile and then in my video camera. If I succeed in my video camera, I will show you. It's loading my document. Okay, in my mobile I can view it, but I cannot work on it. I can share, but I cannot edit. Because as I said, it will be difficult to work.
So ma'am, apart from this drawing and all, we can also, somebody is asking, can we let the students do some other work collaboratively?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You can insert photos. But as I said, Drive has, when it comes to drawing or making a poster or something, this is a good tool. But otherwise, I will meanwhile show you. I will just tell these girls that they can log out if they have some, because they have lot many assignments also. So, So meanwhile, I'll show you. I have already shown you Google Slides. Google Docs, your students can work in a document. They can insert table. And if they have some comparative chart to prepare or something, let me just see. Yeah, this is our one for semester one assignment. We tell them to find out information about organizations which work in the field of educational technology, country, organizational aims, activities of the organization in international settings. So each student is typing in one row, but as a whole, it becomes the whole document for all students to study. See. So this is one use, collaborative use, if we are using documents. Then they are also finding journals. So this was one activity which they did, and then they were told to find out two abstracts of these journals. Now this makes sure that they are reading, going through the journal instead of just typing information and leaving it. Mm-hmm. So this was one assignment where they are generating knowledge collaboratively. And the knowledge is in the same document, accessible to all.
Ma'am, some people are asking, how can we, there are three, four questions on that. How can we use this tool for school level students? Can it be, can you suggest some ways?
Yeah, school level students enjoy concept mapping. We actually think that concept mapping is taught only for higher standards, but no. Many school students enjoy mind map, concept map. They really like it. You can give them some other work also, some drawing work. They can come out with some drawings together. They can make some slides for some informative project together. They are absolutely more creative than our higher education students, I must say. So just try with school students if school students have some device, then it will be useful for them. Because as we just now saw, I tried on my mobile, but you cannot work from your mobile. So that is, of course, limitation of ICT. We cannot really go beyond Telegram and WhatsApp. I'll stop share. Yeah. If you plan to use higher end tools. How much more time do we have? Because I would like to show Jamboard for brainstorming. I can quickly show because there is nothing much in Jamboard.
I'm so quick. I think we should do it. Otherwise.
I'll again share the screen. I just wanted to show you that the same part. When you share, you can click on these names, and once they are done, and if you do not want them to alter anything extra, then you can change this to view. Now Nidhi will not be able to do anything. Okay. So as soon as they finish their work, if we do not want them to play with it or destroy or disturb this, once they are done, then we just keep it in view mode. Or sometimes you can share some documents, make a concept map or any other thing, and you show it to your students, share it with students, and tell them to comment wherever they have query. That is another alternative, that it is your own work, but you are giving students to see that, understand, and comment on it. So these two features are useful. Anyway, I don't think anything more from this. Now we will go to Jamboard. See here, Google only has Jamboard, and even ConceptBoard tool can be integrated with Google. So that also worth exploring. I'll just show you Jamboard and I will stop, because that is again typically for school children when we tell them to brainstorm. So now we can try this here. I have posed a question here, your favorite ICT tool. And let us see how many ICT tools come up here. This is Jamboard. It can be used for brainstorming. And it has sticky notes. Can you all see this sticky notes icon? Yeah, this is the icon. Now, anybody who has this Jamboard shared can click on sticky note. This is the sticky note, and I'm saying that I like Google Drawing. So this Google Drawing sticky note has come here. Then you can shift it anywhere. Again, I can share it. I can get the link. I can, anyone with the link can edit. Now I will stop my screen share, go to chat box. And I will paste this link in the chat box. Are you able to see the link in the chat box? Please click on chat box. This particular session is getting recorded, Mr. Ashutosh. Yeah. Now, 4 or 5 of you, click on the link. Those who have Gmail account, and type, I think there are enough. Please don't join further. It will be chaotic and you won't be able to do anything. Already 30 have joined.
Please stop joining now so that we will be able to understand in a much better manner. 40 people we won't be able to understand.
Now only pick up sticky notes, only sticky notes. Yeah, can you all see? Now this is the pen, and if people just move something like this, then all this becomes shabby. So let me clear this first. And so many have written this sticky notes. You can change color of your sticky note also. I will delete this. Many like H5P. I like that because even H5P is our favorite tool. Now this is name and not the tool, so I'm deleting that. Social media is general category and not ICT tool. So I will delete that. See. Sampath seems to be a name. I don't know. So this is very good tool for brainstorming, and again we can use it for maximum 10 students, 20 students. and then we can talk about it.
Ma'am, can you just quickly repeat from where did you go, because people are getting a little lost.
Yes. See, I have shown you Google drawing. You click on new. I will again show. You go in Google. This is google.com. You are already logged in, provided you have already logged in. So that's why either you can go in Gmail or you can log in into account. Then you click on this Google app at right hand top near your name, Google Apps. And the very first icon is Google Drive. I'm deliberately clicking on Drive and showing other things. But otherwise, Google Slides are here, Google Docs are here, Calendar, Jamboard. So I can either directly click from this Jamboard or I can click on Drive. Once I'm inside Drive, I click on New. First, we can create folder for our students. You can see so many folders I have. So I never get confused. Otherwise, you can imagine so many files. My life will be miserable. So you can create one new folder here and say class 8 B and then April 2, 2020. So whatever I'm doing on my class division B of 8th grade and create. So from your drive, you get this folder. Open that folder. Now there is nothing in this folder. So click on new. And as I said, click on this more. And go to Google Jamboard. Or you can connect more apps. If you don't see Jamboard here, you have to connect more apps and get your Jamboard. So Google Drawing I showed from here and Jamboard I showed from here. And this was the Jamboard which we created. This was another one. Which I had created. This is 21st century. So I can write task like this and others can go on typing and then teacher can arrange it properly. And you can have many frames also. As you go on clicking on this right arrow, you will get so many frames. So once you complete this, then you can click and start next work in other frame, third work in other frame, fourth work in other frame. You can even change these backgrounds. These are a few backgrounds given in Jamboard, not many. And if there is a lot of chaos done by your participants, because students would love to do all these things, even we saw that many adults were doing this now, so don't blame your students. You can just click on clear frame. And this is the sticky note. And then you can have colors. Okay. You can add image also here. You can search image. You can type whatever image search you want. Search for it and get that image if it is free. Or you can have photos. You can go to your own photos. You can go to some files. Fine. Is it clear? And again, the share rules are the same. Share rules are the same. Here also, I haven't shared with specific persons, but I shared with some, I shared link with some. I think I can stop and take up if there are some questions.
Yes, ma'am. Someone is asking, what is the use of laser in this Jamboard?
Achha, laser you can just show when you are using your Jamboard and when you are talking to your students remotely, because they are not sitting with you, right? So that time you can take laser and say that, see this.
Pointer, as a pointer.
Yeah. Right. The use is when, if you use pen and if I do like this, it will not go anywhere. Mm-hmm. It will stay there and make my whiteboard shabby. So when I do like this, Powtoon is useful for, or as I said, there are only 3 Padlets possible now. H5P is very good plugin. So I can do like this. And then the sign will not remain. And these are pen and laser, and these are for moving. Here, this icon is add image icon. So you click on this. You upload your image from your drive or from your device. If you have images in your computer, upload from here. If you have images in your Google Drive, then upload from here. Let me see. So if I want some image from this, then I can directly insert image.
Mm-hmm. And ma'am, is it possible to insert any PDF file or video link here? Or video, etc.
No, because this is brainstorming tool. Yeah. It's spontaneous, right? Mm-hmm. So you are not importing the whole document.
Right.
So Jamboard is just your ideas generation. So you use sticky notes. Or you can draw max to max, or you can insert images and show relationships.
Right.
Can we upload PDF? No. Then.
And ma'am, any other shape can, somebody is asking, people want to be a little creative. So any other shape of the sticky note, is it possible?
No. See. No shape. They have given only colors.
Colors, huh.
There is concept board, I think, has some different shapes. But otherwise, sticky notes generally are like this only.
And can we customize the background?
Background customization, or only these options are given, mm-hmm, as a shape. Mm-hmm. It's a very, very simple tool. Actually, right. All those are paid versions. For example, concept board. We have limitations in concept board. So that is the problem.
For sharing PDF versions and other things, we can use the Google Docs and other things.
Drive. See, I will show you something. This is my Google Drive. I created this. Sorry, I'm not getting the folder now. But
no, that's okay. Actually, we can insert but other things in Google Docs, etc.
See, any folder, any file, you can get shareable link. So you can create my material or learning material or resources. One folder here. my manuals. Yeah, I got it. See, this is the manual which I have created today on how to use Google Drawing. And same way you can use Jamboards. And so I did not make anything for Jamboard, but this is step by step Google Drive. So now if I want to share this, then right click and get the shareable link. Okay. And keep this view. And this is the link. So whomever you want to share this document, share with the link. Mm-hmm. If you want to edit, PDF cannot be edited, but other documents, if you want them to edit, then I showed you how to edit it or how to change settings.
Thank you very much, madam. I think most of the, for a very lucid presentation and also step-by-step instruction, how to access that very particular page and how to work, even demonstrating how collaboratively also we can work. So I hope the colleagues, teachers from universities to school and from NCERT faculty also, we got some idea. And definitely concept maps can be prepared on any particular level, so even from class 1 to PhD. So even wherever they are using, even we mentioned some example, there could be a concept map on food chain, even water cycle, even any other, even food pyramid also. So these are the simple examples that, and madam has very rightly given the example on ADDIE, the instructional design also. So similarly, the utility is much more. Some of you have asked whether if we don't have internet and anything, how can we do? Definitely, you can take a chart paper and collaboratively, Absolutely. Children can draw a concept map in the classroom. And we didn't take many questions except the interaction which we had on chat. But there was a large number of chatting messages shared. And once again, I request, because many of the members are permanent registered members, you need not to again and again register in the portal. Once you have registered, means every time we will send you the link. So don't confuse, don't every time try to register. And we share in most of the groups, and do inform to your friends, those who are interested. And there could be some repetition for you. So please bear with us, because many of us also don't know. So help them to know that and use that tool. So both the tools can very well be used as a teaching tool of any subject. There is no doubt about it. How creatively you are going to use for your students is a $1 million question, and you need to resolve that. And once again, I thank all of you, 300 plus, I think 357 people, they participated.
65,
and,
sir. 365.
So which is very heartening, but we can accommodate till 500. So let's see, this is the beginning, and let us learn more and more tools. Tomorrow also we are going to introduce you some spreadsheet using which you, we can have presentations, graphical presentations, not only in science and math, other subjects also have data presentation can be done. So I, on my personal behalf, on behalf of NCERT, on behalf of all of you, 360 something. So I thank Dr. Jayashree Shindeji for coming and interacting with all of us more than 1 hour. And madam, we will seek similar kind of support from you also in future as well, because many of the university faculty are also here. So we are a diverse group. So starting from schooling to higher education, we are here. Even some of the retired teachers also I could see. So principals also I could see. So there is no age bar of learning. So definitely we should learn. Once again, I thank madam, and I thank
I congratulate you. I congratulate you for this diverse group, bringing this diverse group together.
Yeah, thank you very much. And I thank my colleagues, Nidhi, Devasis and Sarda, for co-hosting and also joining together. So I hope this is beginning for all of us, not end. So let us join together and make a difference and fight for COVID-19. and drive out it from India. Okay, let us commit for that and learn from home. Namaskar. Thank you very much.
Vanakkam. Jai Sri Akal. Thank you.